just a few moments, we have pocket tails.
Tom, like, crazy cherry, like the school girls.
Any folks in the audience create an iPhone app? Anyone? Any developers? We have one iPhone app developer. Did you have to do this? Did you have to stand up in front of a pitch panel? No? You mean you want to do it? No? Okay, you'll pass. It's a little hot up here. All right, Eagles ready? We turned in. For those of you joining us, we're going to be announcing the finalists to head on to tomorrow at 6 o'clock when we finish up here. You guys ready? Judges? You good? Tails, come on up. Please stay on this side of the stage. Do not cross this line, or the cameraman will shoot you.
Let's see how that works. All right.
You good?
Ready.
You set? You sure?
I got this. So. Yep, I'm ready to go.
2 minutes, starting now.
All right. A lot of bookstores and publishers are looking at books right now and asking themselves, you know, how can I make this digital? How can I make this an ebook? Or how can I turn this into an app for the iPad? Well, at Pocket Tales, we ask, how can I take good, old-fashioned print books that children already have access to and make them more entertaining and more educational? You can look at it this way. HDTVs change the way we consume sports, but fantasy leagues change the way we experience sports. And that's what we're doing at Pocket Tales. We're changing the way kids experience books. My name is Brennan. I'm the CEO and co-founder of Pocket Tales, an online social reading game for kids 7 to 12 years old that is ushering in the future of reading. We're doing that in two ways. First, we're making reading more fun by turning it into a game and helping kids find books that they actually like to read. Then, we're making it more educational by focusing on activities that build critical reading skills. Here's how it works. Kids create a reading tribe. Then they add friends to their tribe. Then they read books and take quizzes to earn points. If they pass those quizzes, they unlock additional activities for that book, which earns them points. Then, they review, rate, and recommend books to friends, which helps their tribe and earns them more points. Now, as they're doing all these things, they're also unlocking and discovering badges, which earns them points. And then with all these points, they're able to buy items to customize their avatars and their tree houses. Now, Pocket Tales is a freemium model. The basic gameplay is free, but we charge around $60 a year for kids to have access to additional games. The real hook for kids is that if they're members, they're able to purchase items to customize their avatars and their tree houses that other non-members don't have access to. For parents, being a member means supporting your kids learning critical reading skills and giving them an advantage in both school and in life. So thank you for listening. We are Pocket Tales, and we are changing the way kids experience books. Main component is a quiz. Microsoft's Learning and Accelerated Readers, Scholastic and Reading Counts, they have these big quiz databases that just basically ask questions about books. So we don't need licensing rights for that. Then the other games we have, the other activities, again, are just text-based, for lack of a better word, again. But it's just, we ask kids questions like, write an alternate ending to this book. So the kids are the ones creating the content. We're not using, the image of Harry Potter, the image of Diary of a Wimpy Kid. We might ask kids, name three friends in the Diary of a Wimpy Kid that the Wimpy Kid himself reminds you of. Stuff like that that's social, that's them creating content and them thinking critically about the stuff that they're reading.
My second question is, have you contacted any schools or organizations or booksellers organizations for any kind of support? Because this seems to me like it's a teacher's dream to get kids to read whatever method possible.
Yeah, and it's been really easy to have conversations with teachers, and that's really what we focused on. We focused on children, parents, and teachers, and librarians, and building this out, because if we can get them interested in it, we know the other channels, the other parties, like book publishers, bookstores can fall in line too to help create content for the site. So yes, we talked to teachers, lots of parents, and lots of kids.
And so where's the revenue model then?
The revenue model is premium subscriptions. It's very much a Club Penguin revenue model where you get the basic gameplay to make it viral, but then kids, in order to get access to the additional cool stuff, they have to become members. And as we've seen with Club Penguin, there are 700,000 parents out there who are willing to pay that $60 a year for their kids to just be able to decorate the igloo and decorate their penguin.
Is there a patent on the technology?
No, there's no patent.
Well, it's fun to see Foursquare for Reading. It's wonderful. It's a nice play. I bet it is, right? It's nice. So just a little bit more about your team and why your team's going to do this, because what you just described, I think you may have inspired a dozen people to go out and do this, but it's brilliant. So
right.
I'm just curious what you really, who's behind the curtain besides you?
Right, so my background is I've worked 2 years for a startup in Indianapolis.